photography is always autobiographical because you have to be there in the first place to push the button, but it became much more about my relationship with this place and my love affair with this place, because I did fall in love with this country over a period of time. And I always feel very, you know, my spirits are lifted when I'm here, particularly in this city, actually, where there's a very palpable energy here. And I've experienced a number of photo month festivals now, and I think the energy that's in the city at this time is something the like of which I've never seen anywhere else in the world.
Mark Power jest znanym i cenionym na całym świecie brytyjskim fotografikiem, członkiem jednej z najsłynniejszych agencji fotograficznych Magnum Photos. Jego specjalnością są realizowane przez wiele miesięcy, a nawet lat, projekty fotograficzne o charakterze dokumentalnym. Jednym z takich projektów jest projekt, który prezentujemy w Galerii Międzynarodowego Centrum Kultury, Melodia dwóch pieśni.
I first came to Poland actually in 1989, the winter of 1989. It was my first holiday with my then new girlfriend, who is now my wife. And I have that sort of emotional tie, I suppose, to the country from those very early days. I then returned in April of 1990, and I came as a photographer then. I was very early in my so-called career. You couldn't really call it a career then, I don't think. But I was, the sort of work that I was making was very traditional. The archetypal sort of work that you would expect a foreigner coming to Poland would make. I went to Kalwaria Zebradoszka, for instance, for the Passion Play. I did all the things like that that one is supposed to do. September 2004, I was invited to become to be part of a group project called Eurovisions, which was instigated by Magnum Photos, which is the agency that I belong to. And this was to send 10 European photographers, European-based photographers, to the 10 new European Union countries, the countries that joined the European Union in 2004, which of course included Poland. Each photographer was allotted one country and was asked to spend 1 month there. I was very fortunate, as clearly I was given Poland, and I'm still here. I worked here for a month, two separate 2 week periods, and then there was the show at the Pompidou Center, which toured around Europe and also came to Warsaw.
Postanowił ten projekt kontynuować. Kontynuował go przez kolejne 5 lat, wracał do Polski jeszcze ponad 20 razy i efektem tych powrotów jest archiwum zdjęć liczące ponad 2000 fotografii. Na wystawę Melodia dwóch pieśni, która jest światową premierą tego projektu, Mark Power wybrał 50 fotografii, natomiast do albumu, do książki, która towarzyszy tej wystawie, około 70.
Yeah. this 12-story tower block in Rzeszów.
Tutaj nie będę za dużo opowiadał o tym zdjęciu, bo się nie obawiać, ale to jest 12-piętrowy blok w Rzeszowie.
Was in fact, this is not a... I've been criticized for this picture because I'm photographing yet another 12-story tower block.
Krytykowano mnie za zrobienie tego zdjęcia i pokazywanie, ponieważ mówiono tak, no to następne po prostu zdjęcie 12-piętrowego bloku.
But for me this is an extraordinarily extraordinarily beautiful place.
Ale dla mnie to jest przepiękne miejsce.
The way that the buildings were laid out, there was plenty of space between them.
Po pierwsze, samo rozłożenie tych budynków, aranżacja duże odległości pomiędzy budynkami.
The light was beautiful.
Światło wspaniałe, które pada.
It was raining.
Padało właśnie.
And it seemed that what was happening here was that the local people had got together and were designing color schemes for the blocks of flats.
To, co mnie się wydaje, to, że jednak ludzie tam mieszkający, wielu ludzi, jakoś się zeszło i w jakiś sposób zdecydowało, jak one będą pomalowane.
To lose the grey and to brighten up their home.
I po prostu zmniejszyli obszar tej szarzyzny i zrobili miejsce, w którym żyją piękniejsze.
So what was I looking for? Well, first of all, my quest was quite a on the surface quite a simple one, which was to see how membership of the European Union was going to actually affect Poland. But as time passed, I realized that this was a really impossible task for me.
I have one question about these tires. Did you put them deliberately or did you
jest pytanie see it? To zdjęcie tego, czy
does
to
does it happen incidentally, or did you put them, these four tires?
Czy to po prostu tak było i pan to zobaczył, że to jest tak zaaranżowane?
No, I don't move things. I'm not creative enough to make little sculptures.
Ja nigdy nie przemieszczam przedmiotów. Jestem mało kreatywny, jeśli chodzi o to takie rzeźbiarskie spojrzenie. Nie, ja tego nie robię.
And the world is a remarkable enough place as it is, without me having to intervene.
Świat jest wystarczająco interesującym miejscem bez tego, żebym miał siłowo coś w nim zmieniać.
Of course, Polish people know what this is. This is a place where one would learn to drive.
Oczywiście Polacy doskonale wiedzą, co to jest za miejsce. To jest miejsce, gdzie ktoś się uczy parkować tyły.
British people think that what happens in Poland is when you park your car, they steal the car and leave the tires behind.
Brytyjczycy patrzą na to inaczej. Jak się ma samochód w Polsce, to zaraz zostaną z niego zaledwie opony.
So perhaps it doesn't do very much for Polish-English relations.
To, co powiedziałem, nie jest wielkim wkładem w stosunki polsko-brytyjskie.
Now, when you look at this series of pictures, I suppose you're thinking that I'm attracted to, shall we say, the Tatia side of Poland. I don't think that's true. I think it's just, we have an expression in English, which I'm sure you probably have in Polish too, which is beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And for me, I could never get on with the proper tourist sites that I was supposed to be going to see. I'm not really a fan of castles and palaces and so forth. I'm not very good at enjoying myself in places like that because I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do. So I'm much more interested in little tiny, the sides of the road. The edges of little villages in the middle of nowhere. This is the sort of thing that I find exquisite beauty in. So let me just talk about this triptych here.
Kilka słów chciałbym powiedzieć o tym tryptyku, tych trzech zdjęciach.
You'll see that the reason why this is here is because Isa is has two photographs from the Gdańsk shipyards next to her.
Muszę to powiedzieć, ponieważ Iza, która jest w środku, ma po obu stronach dwa zdjęcia z Gdańska, ze Stoczni Gdańskiej.
And you'll notice that the flapping curtain here on the left is the same as her scarf, almost identical.
I proszę zauważyć, że tutaj ten strzęp jakiejś zasłony na tym zdjęciu niemalże odpowiada tej chuście, którą ona ma na szyi, prawie że ten sam kształt i kolor.
Some of the pictures are quite difficult, they're quite layered with meaning, and I would hope that people would spend time with them. I'm interested in photographs that do make people work, I don't caption my pictures any more than the place where they are made, because I don't want to give too much away.
Are there any final questions?
Czy jeszcze jakieś ostatnie pytania?
Are you planning any other project in Poland in the near future?
Czy przewiduje pan jeszcze jakieś przedsięwzięcia w Polsce w bliskiej przyszłości?
Well, actually, my family, this is Milligan, and Chile is somewhere else, and
moja rodzina to jest Milligan, a Chile gdzieś tutaj jest też w pobliżu.
And my wife Jo, who's somewhere around. We're pardon?
I moja żona.
In camp, they've gone to Camelot.
Yes. Myślałem, że jest tutaj, ale ona już jest w Camelot.
Okay. Well, we're moving to Krakow in August for 6 months.
Przyjeżdżamy do Krakowa w sierpniu na 6 miesięcy.
And we want to do a little book between us, of the four of us, of the adventures of an English family coming to live in Poland.
I ta nasza czwórka, cała moja rodzina, będzie autorami małej książeczki o tym, co my tutaj przeżyliśmy, mieszkając w Krakowie przez 6 miesięcy.